welcome to the How to Add, Edit, and Delete Parts tutorial. In this video, we'll go through some examples of how to add a new part to a specimen record, how to make changes to an existing one, and how to delete one. If you haven't yet, I suggest checking out the Parts Table Overview tutorial to first get oriented. Let's get started. So you can view a specimen's parts on its record webpage. Here we have a northern goshawk as an example. The parts box is on the right-hand side of the screen. And we can see that this record has both a feather and a skull. To view and edit the parts, we're going to click Edit in the top right corner of this parts box. And here we can see those two parts again, lined up on top, and then underneath is a blue box where we can add a specimen part. Let's start over here. So for an example, let's see how to add, if we were to add a frozen tissue to this record, we would start with the part name. And side note, again, like everywhere else on Arctos, the yellow boxes are the required fields. So let's search for tissue. And this window will show the results from that keyword search from the controlled vocabulary Arctos has for part names. We freeze our tissues, so I'll click on Tissue Frozen to select it. Now, if you're ever unsure about what you want to select or if you want to see the definitions of these terms, you can bring up a master list by clicking Define Values up in the top here. And this shows the entire list of ways that you can have a part name. We can narrow this list down a little bit by going to Show Only Collection Type and select Bird, because we are dealing with a bird here, from that dropdown, and click Filter. And then we're dealing with tissues, so we can scroll down alphabetically to where tissues would be. And there we go, Tissue Frozen. We can do is just copy and paste this directly in here to avoid any errors. And moving on, we'll put count as one. We'll put disposition as in collection. We'll just put good for condition. And I'm going to add muscle as the remark to add some more detail. And we don't use barcodes on our frozen tissue containers, so I will leave this last one blank and click Create when I'm ready. Okay, so our third part has now been added. And so that's the main way of adding parts, but there's two other ways to add parts to a record. The first being cloning and the second being subsampling. So I'll have you take a look at this cluster of buttons over on the right-hand side where you can see clone and subsample, the two blue ones. These are special situations if you'd want to add a part. Let's go over cloning. Cloning would be if you were to add a similar part or one that has the same exact information, and it's a kind of a way to save time instead of starting from scratch. So for example, let's say we wanted to add another type of frozen tissue to this record. What we would do is click clone for the tissue, and notice that it auto-filled that information into the add specimen part box and noted that it was cloning that specific part. What we can do is make any adjustments needed, like changing muscle to liver, and note that disposition will autofill to being processed, so make sure to change that if you need to. And we're all set, so let's click create again, and there's our another one. So that's just a time saver if you're adding multiple similar parts. The last way to add a part is by subsampling. Now this would be if you were to create a new part from a parent part. For example, like if we were to split this liver tissue into two different vials, we want to maintain that relationship, that lineage, instead of having two independent parts, we can create a subsample. So let's go ahead and try that. Click subsample, click OK. And again, it auto-filled that in, and now it's saying it's creating a subsample of this specific part. Again, we can just make our small adjustments and click Create. And here's our next one lined up. But you can see that it's got this hyperlinked header here, subsampled from, and then the ID number of the parent. We can click on this to have it highlight that parent so we don't have to go hunting for it. So those are the ways that you can add a part. Now let's talk about editing. This is the same window that you can make all of your edits in. Again, if you need to get here from the beginning, at the record page, it's on the right-hand side, the parts box, and the upper right-hand corner of that, the edit button. So you can make any adjustments to any of these fields as needed and click Save All Changes when you're ready. This can include adding the part to a barcoded container where you can either scan it directly in or enter it by hand. And once you hit Save All Changes, all those changes will be enacted. It's important to note that we're not limited to just these attributes though. If we wanted to add additional optional attributes, we can do that. The way you would do that is through this Manage Attributes orange button here. So for example, let's say we wanted to add a storage location to this feather, like a room number where it was being stored. What we could do is click on Manage Attributes for the feather. And the first thing you would do is select which attribute you would like to add from this drop-down menu. There's quite a few things you can choose from, whether it's tissue quality, collecting event date, and other IDs, but we'll go ahead with location because that's the one we use the most here, and it's probably pretty common. So then you'll be able to add your value, like room 101. You can add date, determined by, or remarks if needed, but when you're ready, click Create. Okay. And again, this is how you can edit and delete these extra attributes. If you wanted to make adjustments, you can in these fields and click Save Edits. If you wanted to delete this outright, you can click this checkbox under Delete and click Save Edits. But otherwise, we'll just go ahead when we're done and close the window. Now note that it doesn't show up right away, and neither will it show up on the main page itself until you refresh the whole thing. Okay, so now we can see here are the new parts we added and that attribute that we added. So the last thing of this tutorial will be how to delete a part. So again, we can bring up the edit window here. And if there's a part you want to delete, you can just go follow it over to the right-hand side, and there's that orange, that dark orange delete button. You can click on that and then click on OK to confirm that. And now it's gone. So this concludes the how to add, edit, and delete parts tutorial. Be sure to check out the parts table overview tutorial if you needed some introduction first. And there's also a bundle of other tutorials related to specimen parts that are available through Arctos. Thanks for watching.